out of three. Only going to be the one match today with a lot of reschedules and whatnot happening once again. But we do got a match that should be a good match. With that said, of course, that's really, again, this whole format with this event and everything, any really day, any match definitely can prove to be a good one. So looking forward to that. With that said, we got The Last of Us, of course, taking on Reason Gaming here. As you see, The Last of Us, I don't think we've covered these guys so far in the season. And go figure, it comes, you know, with pretty much the last weekend here. But hey, it's better now than never at this point. And I'm looking forward to it, seeing what they what they're about to bring it to the table. With that said, of course, I am joined by a co-cast today, new co-caster. I haven't had him on before, but he's been cast a little bit recently with others. Mini Maggot going to be joining me. How's it going, man?
Hello. Yeah, I'm good, man. I'm looking forward to this game. It's going to be a good game.
Yeah, we were obviously had you on just shortly before as they're setting up and everything, getting ready for this. And again, you're kind of, you know, breaking down. You actually got the chance to cast, I think it was Reason versus Sync on Thursday. So you were making points that you're really impressed by Reason's play, and they've definitely been proving themselves pretty strong lately.
Yeah, they've been really, really strong, actually. Particularly Probrass. I've been really impressed by him play, but particularly Imberboy's drafting as well. I know Saints Rock has been drafting at the start, but they sort of Imberboy has taken over, and I think their drafting has improved drastically. But yeah, this game's going to be really good, though. I know Last of Us actually beat Reason Gaming the last time they matched up. It was covered by Coldcast, if I remember correctly, and they Reason. Yeah, they 2-0'd Reason, so I think Reason want to get their own back at the moment, so I'm looking for a good game today.
That's a very good point. Actually, that just so happens to be the only series win so far this season for The Last of Us. Go figure against Reason here. They've played six series in total, so they still have four more to go, including this one. So, and again, they've definitely proven. They've taken a game off at BMG, even. We talked about that. We were talking about that earlier. I mean, so this team most certainly can compete. And again, you probably recognize some names over there, too. Of course, representing the American scene. So looking forward to seeing what they bring here. But, you know, obviously we got a lot of draft already picking up here, so let's kind of quickly go over this here. The initial bands: Electrician, Kronos, Puppet, Warbeast, Drunken, Engineer, Rhapsody, Keeper of the Forest, Magnus, and Pebble so far the picks. Real quickly on the Electrician band, Meisty, I had him co-casting me in the Ariza versus Sync series actually on Wednesday this last week, and he especially was making mention. He was so impressed with Zane's Electrician play. I'm not surprised to see Electrician banned here because of that.
Yeah, it's a really strong pick, and Zane's been playing really strong with it. But another hero that he's also really strong on is actually Keeper of the Forest. I've seen him match up against Dr. Repulsor in lanes he shouldn't really be winning, yet he still does fantastic. So you have to definitely keep an eye on Zane this game.
Oh, yeah. And again, what he ends up with. But as far as these picks coming out here, what do you think how the draft's going, especially on Reason's set, you know, going that earlier on Keeper pickup here?
Yeah, I think it's mainly just to pick up for Zane, though. I know Keeper of the Forest has been sort of out of the meta game for a while, but it's coming back. I think it's mainly because it's sort of versatility, particularly because it can still run Suicide, I mean, as Zane has shown, but also it can sort of still jungle as well at the same time. Mm-hmm. But I think the Engineer and Pebbles pick is a strong pick, though. I know Reason of sort of really liking their sort of dual support, so picking up a strong hero like Engineer that can work in a dual lane or a tri lane is a strong pickup from Imberboy.
Yeah. You know, and again, we look at the standings. I've shown them before the match, but real quickly, just to make a point of this, going into this weekend, and I believe there's even right now a match scheduled to happen on Monday, so kind of leaking over into next week. Technically, though, this is the last weekend here of the regular season. Again, you really got BMG and Sync Esports. They're playing for that 1-2 seed going into the playoffs. And then these other four teams, though, they're pretty much competing to, well, not have to play in a relegation match and also get a chance of earning some decent prize pool money in the playoffs, of course, as the top four eventually make it. The bottom two, of course, have to play in those relegations. So that's kind of what's on the line here, once again, in this matchup.
Yeah, because Last of Us are actually bottom with only 5 points, and so them and Team Excellent are on the relegation zone at the moment, so they really need at least one win here to get back into good standings in the league.
Exactly. The next tier of bands coming out, though: Flux, Torturer, Tempest, Ophelia, Slither, and Pyromancer. So a lot of AoE synergy. Again, Flux taking out the Seority with the Keeper and Engineer, especially on that side. You know, definitely put some sense to that. But overall, anything standing out to you with these bands necessarily?
I'm not too sort of impressed by the bands coming out from Meisty, though, because not because the Flux is in a good band, but it's because like they've already got Pebbles for Probrass mainly going to be playing that, and it's like Flux obviously is a strong combo with Engineer, but it's just there's no way Reason could really lane a Flux in this lineup in my opinion. Yeah. And same with Tempest. I mean, Keeper and Tempest is such a strong combo, but it's like, are they really going to sort of pick it up? And I really don't think so. So those bands are almost sort of not a non-factor in this draft, in my opinion. Mm-hmm. On the other side, though, the bands coming out from Immerboy are a lot better, in my opinion, though, because I mean, they've banned out like a Torturer, a very strong pick, and sort of Slim, sort of Aphelion, Pyromancer, which is something that The Last of Us could pick up, but Assault is picking up from here from The Last of Us.
Yeah, I was looking at, obviously, kind of going over these rosters here. It's The Last of Us especially. They do run the jungler. What you got, he plays their jungle. They like to get him a jungler. Usually, Ophelia, Parasite, and Warbeast are actually his top-played heroes. He has played Solstice a couple times, and of course, Solstice has been a jungler flavor for a lot of teams to pick up lately. Moon Queen, though, as we just see right there, coming out. So
yeah. I mean, like, Moon Queen is such a strong hero, especially sort of matched up with Keep of the Forest. The one sort of quibble I've got, though, with Reason is because though they run a lot of sort of early game aggression. They like to get the Probust, like the early portal key, and like to take map control and gain sort of early dominance. But with the Moon Queen, Keep of the Forest, it's not something that I've seen Reason play a lot, and so I'm not sure how strong they can sort of execute this. But, I mean, they're obviously great players, so they should be able to play any sort of strategy Imberboy or Saintrox gives them. But,
yeah. Definitely. So, we are going to be having a remake here, as you see in the chat. Obviously, just their official fifth. Apparently, Fuzzy Sloth is their official fifth of the team, in place of Creams, actually. Which again, Creams has been a player that's been around has had history in the scene. Of course, has dropped off a lot lately, but came back with this team to an extent. Clearly, not a full time player by any means, but helping when needed. But it looks like again, their fifth is ready. And so we'll just have a quick remake here in old pick. But that final pick, though, for Reason Gaming, as you're saying, they're going to be coming out. Obviously, they already have the keeper, so not exactly sure.
They'll have to take another supporter, because although Moon Queen can short lane against like sort of aggressive heroes like Drunken Master in the suicide lane, Drunken will completely dominate Moon Queen here. So I think they're going to look for their other support, because I mean, Engineer, not the greatest sort of short lane support. So I'm assuming a support is what they're going to pick up, and then just send the suicide keeper with a dual mid of Engineer and Pebbles.
Yeah.
But I could be mistaken. But I think like sending Moon Queen short lane is quite risky, because you want to get the good farm early on so she can snowball. So I'm just wondering what support they could pick up. Aluna, Glacius. It's just a safe pick, because although Moon Queen short lane can work, it's kind of risky, and with sort of the late game presence they've got with Keeper of the Forest and Moon Queen, they don't need to make any of those kind of early game risks, so it's just safe to pick up another support here.
Yeah. Now, Keeper of the Forest, it's been interesting with Keeper as far as his presence kind of making a comeback to an extent. And again, it's not in the jungle, of course. It's been a little bit at that suicide roll now. He got those nerfs a while back. The whole intention was that we don't want you suiciding because you're too strong for it. But again, he is making a little bit of a comeback. His AoE, I think people are realizing once again, obviously in the Nature's Veil too. Do you agree with this, where it was wrong for him to kind of disappear, that it makes sense that he's coming back here?
Yeah, I mean, I think a lot of people do, and I know I do it sometimes at the same time, is that if a hero gets nerfed, it's almost like a taboo, and everyone sort of stays away from the hero itself.
Yeah.
When in actual fact, the hero can still be good just because it's been nerfed. It's just not as good as it was, but not as good as it was is still better than some other heroes, if that makes any sense.
Oh, no, of course. So
yeah, I think the hero is still good, but also I think it requires that kind of certain player to play it. Because I know, like, if you haven't played a hero for a certain while, the hero itself loses effectiveness. But I mean, I've seen Zane completely dominate on that Keep of the Forest, so
yeah.
He's definitely in safe hands in this game.
Again, real quickly, as we are doing this remake here, yes, there is another match going on. Obviously, we were only able to cast one of the matches. Can't cast them both at once, unfortunately. But Sync versus Rekstars is playing, and actually, again, expecting that. Again, this whole series really looking to be good. It got kind of an interesting game over there going. Sync's running a Flint Beastwood, actually, carry, it looks like. And it looks like it's a pretty close game on top of that. So keep an eye on that to see how those results turn out. But, yeah, Flint Beastwood. No. wasn't expecting to hear of him today, but hey, that's
can work.
Apparently, and it seems like he's 5-1-8 in that game right now, so doing pretty good for Sync Esports
there. Going back to the draft of The Last of Us, though, I can't remember all 100% of the heroes, but it seemed that they had a little bit of counter synergy. I know they picked up the Solstice and the Soul Reaper, and although Soul Reaper's a good hero, I like to see him in kind of in a sort of a pushing lineup, kind of a, that kind of team strategy. Mm-hmm. Because otherwise, it's like you might as well pick another sort of short lane hero for it. And that kind of counter synergy, I'm not too fond of in the draft. Like, obviously, you want to have a game plan or a game set in mind, and then revolve your draft around that kind of game plan.
Yeah.
And it seems that The Last of Us have sort of just almost picked like sort of the laning sort of phase, because I mean, Soul Reapers is a really strong laner against, you know, particularly the Keeper of the Forest. I remember back in the day where Keeper of the Forest was really strong, and that was one of the only heroes to work against it. If I remember, like, Trouf used to talk about how he could sort of work against Keeper of the Forest. But the only problem is that they don't really have the heroes to sort of revolve around Soul Reaper. And I like that kind of early push, because obviously his Q, obviously healing all the minions, and although it can still be useful in team fights, it's just not the same, not everything working as it sort of should in mm-hmm. sort of the drafting synergy.
Yeah.
But we'll have to see how it works in the game, though, because, you know, anything can happen.
Yeah, Soul Reaper definitely is just one of those niche heroes, of course. That's a bit on scene, kind of what you're getting at right there. So, will this work out for The Last of Us? Obviously, that's they're hoping for, and as you put it in, as it usually is. Of course, we'll have to wait and see how it ultimately comes together. But yeah, definitely, again, with that Drunken, too, he likes that physical presence and not a whole lot of synergy in that sense either. So
yeah, that's fun. But a thing that's quite interesting here is actually mid lane should have a real advantage, though, because particularly because of the Solstice and the Magmus combo. Because obviously you got Solstice sort of the ganking potential of his Q, but you need a, sort of a setup stun, and Magmus offers that perfect setup stun because of it's sort of it's almost like a rally compel that you you stun in, but you're also in at the same time, and so yeah. Solstice and the Magmus combo should really have an advantage in the middle lane. Particularly against pebbles with a lone armor. So I'm looking for Legion to win middle lane, without a doubt.
All right, well, here we go. Officially, it looks like game number one going to be coming at us. The Last of Us versus Reason Gaming once again here on a Saturday. Our only series here today that we're going to be covering. But again, expecting it to be a great one. So into the laning phase. Yeah, Solstice, he again, kind of one of these heroes that's been a bigger presence as of late in that jungle especially. And we've seen him both be dominant, especially in the ganking role, being active, but also, you know, not turn out so well. So obviously, as really any hero would be, I guess. So early laning phase, where are they going to go here?
Yeah, if I help on it, should be quite stunning, though. Engineer, Pebbles, dual mid, Keeper, Suicide, and then Moon King getting sacked by the Luna. Mm-hmm. And then I just assume Soul Reapers go bottom, Solstice in the own jungle, Magmus, Rhapsody mid, and then Drunken top. But yeah, I really like the Solstice pick, though, because like Solstice is really strong if you can sort of have that kind of early game presence, which you will have in the dual mid, but also you won't be harassed too much because he's not going against a trial, he's just going to be going against a solo keeper in the long lane.
Yeah.
So he should sort of be able to get his farm, but also have presence in the middle lane and potentially bottom as well if they get like an early gust and Zane plays sort of too aggressive. But you can see actually Zane already sort of seeing this. Really. He put like an early ward down the bottom lane to see any Solstice ganks, and that's really key though, because Solstice sort of needs those early ganks. He isn't the fastest farmer, so getting those early ganks can really boost up his farm early on in the game.
Yeah. Yeah, as you see right there, yeah, the ward of sight going down, so going to have that information, as you're pointing out. Again, Soul Reaper at that bottom side. And so do you think Keeper of the Forest should actually have an okay time, or are you still expecting to be boxed out and not do too well here?
He should be doing maybe like average farm, maybe like around 200, 220, but at the same time, this is Zane, so his Keeper of the Forest is like another level compared to other Keeper of the Forest. But I think definitely Soul Reaper will win this lane, but not as strong as like a normal matchup would from Soul Reaper, because like you really can't underestimate Zane's Keeper. Like it's one of the best if I've ever seen like a Keeper of the Forest, but he really does really well on boxing out with his Animate the Forest. But yeah. I think Soul Reaper definitely have the advantage in this lane.
Interesting. You see what he's doing right here? He's actually pulling the creep wave back with the dog, and he's kind of just sitting here on the auto attacks.
This is another key thing, because, like, look at all that harass that Soul Reaper's already taken. Like, and he's only got, like, a 6 set of trees, and he's already used one at the same time. Like, Zane just really knows this hero pretty well.
Oh, yeah.
So, actually, an interesting matchup. They're sending dual top, actually. I'm really, really not key fan of this, though, because as you see, they're running the Solstice jungle, right? So they can't really rotate Solstice into the other jungle, and so they're sending a dual lane top, and it's just going to be matched by a tri lane, and this tri lane is obviously going to take out the dual lane, so I really, really don't like the decision coming up from The Last of Us.
Yeah, so that's definitely a... I mean, even though it means that they're sending another resource in here, and as far as the support goes, you're still fine with that as far as...
Yeah, it's definitely fine, but they need, like, what Reeds need to do is just make sure they get like a lot of farm on Moonquin, and then they can do this with this tri lane. But it looks like Rhapsody's going back. Like, this is what I mean. Like, they sent out the Rhapsody top, and now he's going back mid because he knows he can't do anything against a tri lane. So they're sort of just wasting time there. But at the same time, like, they are throwing down pebbles to an extent, but he's still got like amazing farm. So yeah. Like, it just seems like a little bit of maybe there's miscommunication of what they wanted to do. I'm not 100% sure, but like, yeah, they're scared of the Moonquin getting a lot of farm, but the way they've sort of drafted, there's no way they can really shut him down in the laning phase. They can shut him down like in the mid game by setting ganks up, perhaps with Magnus. But in the laning phase, there's nothing they can do because Reason a lot better an answer to address.
Yeah, and it's also kind of interesting with the roles here too. You know, again, I was pulling up the stats and everything for these teams, especially The Last of Us, kind of getting a better read on who plays what. As Magnus taking a lot of pressure at the top lane, he's gonna be fine. But speaking of him being played by Diglett, normally their carry player, but in this case, Beaver Banger actually is gonna be their kind of carry presence here on a Soul Reaper. So a little bit of a mix up there, but hey, you know, not the biggest deal in the world. Oh, middle lane though. Solstice Invis.
This should be... They might go on Engineer actually instead.
Oh, yeah. Look at that. It's not the most... A beautiful time kick. Still, though, from Atro. In comes the stalagmites. Atro's going to live. Wow. And actually, Rhapsody, he might be in a little bit of trouble if Engineer can get back in. No, he cannot. But holy crap. That kick stun timing, man.
Yeah, like Adro, I mean, I've said it before. Like, I really rate Adro as a support player. He knows exactly what he needs to do, and he executes everything perfectly. The one thing we do need to like mention though is Drunken's didn't actually spec his lunge. He went one point in Trink, and I think if he did spec that lunge, he would have easily got a kill on Magma on Pebbles, excuse me. Which is a little bit of an issue, but not the biggest deal. Like they didn't spend too much time, but yeah.
Yeah, that was a very, very close call, but in the end, obviously, it doesn't work out. Not into backfire necessarily, but there's been a bit of resources. But yeah, back to the middle lane. We do see them chasing out onto the Rhapsody right here. Engineer, though, in the background, taking a lot of damage himself. Who goes down first? It will be Bloodlust for, oh, looks like the Legion team, as Mycy Bro gets credit right there, even playing the Rhapsody. So right before he goes down, they get the credit. Yeah. So that's, I guess, in Last of Us' favor there.
Definitely. But one thing I would like to point out, though, you see the ward that Legion have in the bottom lane? They've got a bottom rune ward, which is fine, but I'd prefer if the rune ward was top, because as you see, you got the two supports coming out from Reason, and they're obviously going to have some rotation, and there's no need for this rune ward to be bottom. They could have it top, and that gank would have not been successful if the rune ward was top, because they'd obviously spot out Luna. Mm-hmm. Just a little quibble, obviously, because they don't really need this. They can have a rune ward, but there's no need for it to have it bottom, because there's no danger from Keeper really roaming.
Yeah. Oh, middle lane. Yeah, Pebbles. When we're out of attack, and actually, Mycy Bro comes in just to secure the kill, really. But in the end, he even gets credit for it. But yeah, that was. I mean, Probosc was playing that pretty ballsy initially, and even if it was just a Drunken Master, he could have very likely fallen anyway. So you got to wonder what Probosc was thinking there as far as sticking in so much.
But Pebbles has completely. He's got one armor at the moment, and Drunken is completely physical, and like he's going to get completely destroyed in middle lane. So that's probably what Last of Us were thinking to run Drunken mid instead of the Magnus.
Yeah.
An aggressive ward top, actually. They might be trying to dive this Magnus very shortly, and there's no other reason to put that ward there. They're not going to try and dive him.
I mean, Moon Queen, she's level 5. Maybe she's going to hit level 6 here soon. I mean, might wouldn't need it in the end, but there we go. Moonbeam, Aluna. She has a power throw lined up. Comes to a Magnus. Magnus not realizing the tower's doing some damage though, to Moon Queen. Magnus doesn't have mana for his Lava Surge, though. One more. I don't think. Oh, wasn't enough. No power throw mana. He's going to use a mana. Oh, there goes the Steam Bath, though. And Aluna cannot do anything about this.
Oh. Wow. Like, I think that was a little bit of a misplay by Ember Boy. He was one attack away. I think he was scared of getting stunned, which was fine, but I think that one auto attack would have definitely made a difference, but it's not the biggest of deals. But that ward, you know, is definitely paying off already. He's sending Magnus back all the way to the well.
Oh yeah. How about this, by the way? Oh, back to the middle lane. Once again, no surprise to see a little bit of action, but no kills coming out.
But this is what I was saying back to the... Oh, actually, there might be more action middle lane. They're trying to say... Oh, stun just
missed. Lagmite's just missed. Yeah, Puppet Master... Or Drunken Master, excuse me, going back in. On a Pebbles right there. Staccato's to follow, but not nearly enough damage. And here comes Aluna, actually. This could backfire. Fuzzy Sloth realizing that, and he just quickly falls back. So the Aluna rotation is unsuccessful as a result of that.
Yeah, and this goes back to the rune ward bottom. Like I said, if they had a rune ward top, there's no way they're going to get ganked here in the middle lane. But
yeah.
What was you going to say, sorry, before?
Bottle on Keeper of the Forest. I find that interesting. A Suicide Keeper going to Bottle first.
Yeah, Zane always goes Bottle, though, whenever he goes in a 1v1 matchup. I think it's because he wants that presence for the Animate Forest. Because I see him do it a lot, actually. He spawns his trees and then he sends them on whoever's on the short line, and they really do get boxed out. I know it's kind of a Dota 2 strat with Nature Prophet, actually. I've seen them before. So, middle lane.
Probust is going to get away from this one. Stalagmus going. The creep wave blocking a little bit right there. The Bottle Charger's not going to be enough to save himself. Probust, good timing. Between the auto attacks.
Great play. Like, he had regen bottled up and he staggered that perfectly with the bottle charges. Yeah. He was clicking the bottle charges every single time the auto attack was off cooldown from Rhapsody. That was really well played by Probust there.
Yeah, those creep waves definitely can be a bit of a nuisance right there, but in the end, manages to. Wow, we've had a lot of close calls this game.
Yeah, man.
Both sides already.
So close. But going back to the bottom line, like, as expected, I mean, Keeper's not doing too badly, but he is going to be getting zoned up by Solrig. But it's just because. The Withering Presence and the Judgment is just too much harass for him, so he's just going to go and get some reliable farm, most likely on the Ancients or the jungle. Mm-hmm. He's just going to go in the enemy jungle. Or he might be trying to set up a gank mid, actually. Pretty well played. He's got the Nature's Veil and the Animated Forest. This might be a kill. Oh, middle lane.
Ward of Sight is going to spot the trees at least coming in, so you got to figure, although they can't see Keeper himself.
They must know.
Something probably up. you wouldn't just be sending trees in for a gank by itself, so.
Yeah, but that's a good play coming out from. Oh, but look, they even see the ward mid actually because of that.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, but that's a good play coming out from saying, like, if you're not really like contesting in your lane, you might as well try and be useful otherwhere by ganking and stuff. So yeah. That's just a nice play.
Okay, Alchemist Bones just finished on Solstice. He's gonna be doing his quiet thing, but he's got some good farm. 280 gold per minute, just about.
Yeah, that's good farm for a Solstice. The only problem though is that like he's gone Alchemist Bones, which is fine, but at the same time, like, they're going to be trying to go late game against a Moon Queen and the Keeper of the Forest, and that's something you're not 100% sure you want to do. I mean, they might be able to potentially sort of take it late game, because they do have the Drunk of the Master and the Solstice, but in the end, I think Moon Queen and Keeper will slightly sort of late game.
And that's just where the awkwardness of the lineup goes. I mean, you brought it up. It's just the Soul Reaper. It's like, it just doesn't feel right.
But yeah, I mean, I think, because it's like, They've got heroes for sort of different game plans. They've obviously got like the Soul Reaper sort of for the push, and then they've got the sort of Solstice for the gank and late game, and then Drunken, and then Magmus for sort of team fight. And it's just like it seems like they don't have like 100% game plan or game strategy they want to play. Oh, middle bottom lane. I know Keeper's coming over for a gank again. Middle lane.
This time without the trees. Not gonna give that much information away. There is no red ward or anything. Do they have anything on them? It doesn't look like it. No, they do not. So. This could be danger if they're not careful. Granted, Pebbles nor Engineer aren't actually anywhere nearby. They're doing some pulls currently. Also farming up their own jungle here. So I don't know if that was miscommunication or what, but the timing was kind of off right there.
Yeah, it must have been a little bit miscommunication. But at the same time, it's a good play coming out from Pebbles, though, because they saw Magmus actually off from the top lane. They don't want to get ganked, so it's easier just to get you reliable farm in the jungle in the end.
And in the meantime, tower exchanging going to happen here.
Yeah, that's the strength of Solrig, but like you can't lane against him, and if you're not laning against him, then you can just take the tower really easily. But Reason do sort of counter it with their own push top.
Yeah. Oh, middle lane Pebbles actually does a little bit of rev ward right there, but stagger away from Drunken. He kind of almost faked like he was going on him, but chose not to fully commit by any means. So speaking of the Soul Reaper once again, it's just because it's a funky game. But even so, I mean, what kind of item build do you expect to see on this guy?
I mean, this hero is really quite situational. You can get like a various sort of iron build. Like, if they want to go late, they could even go Grimmer of Power. But if they want to sort of start getting in team fights, then go Icon. That's a really good item on him as well. I think that's the two main iron builds. I mean, he could
more
maybe go
tablet maybe for utility.
Yeah, potentially. But it's just that's what I mean. Like, the draft in this game is really sort of weird. Like, you got one thing going for another, and I'm really sort of confused on what they want to do.
I'm on board with you.
Like, I mean, I think Grimmer's probably the most safest thing they can do because it sort of works both ways. They can still sort of team fight with the item, but they can obviously farm and go late game as well. So I think he might be going Grimmer. Yeah. He's saving up all this gold as well, which suggests he might be going Librand.
Is that the best choice? That's kind of like, again, you already have a farming source in the middle lane. In the meantime, Drunken Master, Power Throw comes through as well. Can he get away from this one? Untouchable is up, mitigating some damage. He staggers away initially. Pebbles cannot get close enough. Chuck in 2 seconds. The Solstice Ultimate with the Fear coming out. They're turning this around right here. Down goes one on Engineer. Aluna's not going to take some good damage. He goes down. Beautiful bait right there coming out.
Wow. And that's the power of Solstice, though. Like, you saw, like, how much damage it did, though, and, like, all the way for, like, area effect as well, like, really did turn that fight. Like, it was looking really bad for Drunken Master there, but
yeah.
Massive Solstice, though, and that's the difference. And look, like, they're, like, 3,000 XP and 2.5 gold up as well, like, and they're really looking good, actually, right now for The Last of Us.
Man, that's, yeah, it's, again, Solstice is still kind of a newer hero on the competitive scene, but that's one of the bigger plays you're going to see a Solstice make, definitely. Again, just some good teamwork, though, like I said, with the baiting. But, again, that kind of goes back. Now he's got Steam Boots finished. So, again, Solstice really is 366 gold per minute now. You got Swordbird, 360 GPM, and Drunken Master, 360 GPM. So all across the board. Good for them.
Bottom lane, potentially. I don't think they have the damage to kill him, actually, with Luna. So I don't know what Luna's doing here. Unless they bring Pebbles over, I don't think they're going to kill the Soul Reaper. So that's a little bit of a weird play. Going back to what I was going to say, but Gnome's Wisdom picks up by a Soul Reaper, which is another kind of weird item, Gnome's Wisdom, because obviously that's more of a pushing item, and it doesn't look like they're doing a lot of pushing. All tier 1 towers are up except for bottom lane, so
there's not really physical presence over here on the Hellborn side, a whole lot of it at least yet. It's still like, I don't know.
In my opinion, I don't really like that item build, though, because like, I think they need sort of magical damage presence, because obviously Keeper of the Forest offering a lot of armor, sort of negating a lot of what Drunken Master's going to be doing, as well as Solstice, and so they need that kind of differing damage, sort of damage source, which obviously force the enemy teams to pick up vestments, sort of slowing them down on their gold progression. But that's why I'm not too fond of the Gnome's Wisdom. I would prefer the Grimmel, but it's still like not a bad item build. It's going to help him for farm as well as team fight. But I think Grimmel would have been a little bit of a better choice. But I don't really know what's going on, what their calls are. They might be trying to push soon, so that would have been a good item build as well.
Yeah, I mean, that's where obviously, you know, it does make a little more sense, as you said, with the push perhaps. But again, does that even make sense with the team makeup? So, we've been caught up on that enough, and again, just going to have to wait and see how that kind of progresses on. But Portokey, by the way, picked up by Pro Bus. You can see in the middle lane, they're going for it, or they want to at least, but no, it's not going to happen. Yeah, he's going to show it.
That's going to be a really big pickup, though, because you see, like, Reason are down by like 3,000 gold and about 4,000 experience, and this is what the exact core pickup they need to sort of make action and aggression happen. Because Moon Queen's all good, you know, like getting into the late game, but it's the late game that she needs, and this is where Pebbles is going to really need to give the space for Moon Queen to farm, because otherwise they're going to be tracking behind, and this is going to be hard to sort of get back in the gold deficit.
Yeah. Solstice, I wonder if he's setting up a Hame Kamei. Yes, he is. Here we go. The ultimate. Will it go off the top? Yes, it will. The fear comes out. TP's definitely coming in. Give it the force. Can he actually escape from this? Doesn't look like it. Dust is used. No, they don't have dust. Okay.
That's kind of a little bit of a weird play, though. It must, like, it's a great idea to go up for a gank, though, but you have to have that dust.
Yeah.
Because otherwise, like, I mean, they TP'd all bottom, and now this leaves open potential push coming up from mid, as well as just extra more farm for the Hellborn side. But look, they're pushing mid, though. Souls is always down, and I'm not sure if Legion can really contest this now, actually. And it's dropping quite fast. Sorry if it does have a TP. Oh, no, it's TP and cooldown. Like, Legion can't defend this if Hellborn push.
I mean, this is why Reason's pushing. Obviously, they know what the TP situation now. They are going to get there in time, though. I mean, they get there in time at least just by running over.
Yeah, Keeper and Moon Queen went there for the push, but even though they didn't get that tower, though, they put a lot of pressure onto it. It's also a lot of farming time, which they needed just for Moon Queen to get as far as she can.
And, you know, if they just simply spent, 180 gold on dust, that was a guaranteed absolute kill on Keeper of the Forest.
Definitely. But not only that, though, it's the gold they sort of wasted from all the TPs and as well as the time trying to set up that gank. But I guess, I mean, if Rapture's got dust now, but it's just obviously a little bit too late. But not the biggest of issues. They're still up by quite a bit, so as long as they sort of don't lose this game. The main thing, though, is that they need to make sure they don't get picked off by this Pebbles. Like, Pebbles is really the only key hero they have here to really sort of get Reason back in the game. As long as Pebbles doesn't have like the big impact which Reason want them to have, Last of Us can be in a really good situation.
Now, speaking of Moon Queen, again, got the Whispering Helm, another 1800 gold saved up. This is where we usually see more than likely maybe into that Firebrand and then into the Shrine. I mean, that kind of route here. You expect that to just be a normal Moon Queen game, nothing out of the ordinary.
It's one of those heroes. Moon Queen's one of those heroes that you have to go that kind of item build, really. I expect the Geomancer's Bane before the Shrunken, actually, because it doesn't look like they're doing that much farming. They're more sort of like just farming, so they don't really need to team fight, really. So the Geomancer's Bane would be fine to pick up, to be honest.
Yeah, but boy, taking out some triple stack ancients right here with the assistance of Engineer coming out. But again, so he's up to the GPM tier, but you got Solstice, Soul Reaper, and Drunken Master all basically competing with that Moon Queen at this time. So
Yeah, oh, Paul's coming out. But what I'd like to see from Legion right here, actually, I'd like to see first the Shrunken Head coming out from... Oh, actually, there's initiation in middle lane, but it's kind of paused. If you can see, like, the Stalagmite is kind of, like, coming out. Yeah. I think that might just be to farm, actually.
Yeah, I don't think they're going for a kill.
But yeah, going back to what I was going to say, though, I think what Legion's sort of game plan in here is they've got, like, sort of a three-core sort of going on with Soul Reaper, Drunken, and Solstice. And I'd like to see them sort of push the issue, because I don't think they have that much presence to go in the late game. They don't really need to go late game because they're already quite far ahead. So I'd like to see the Shrunken on Drunken Master, maybe another item on Solstice and another one on Soul Reaper, and then like sort of force the issue, because Moonqueen won't have the Shrunken by then, and that's kind of all they've sort of got for late game sort of physical damage.
Yeah.
So with Shrunken on Drunken, like, he'll be just be going ham on whoever he wants. And that's what I'd like to see from Legion. On the Hellborn side, though, I think they need to do a lot of dodging, though, because I think they do potentially have the better late game, as long as Keeper gets the resto and Moonqueen gets as farmed as possible. I think they want to dodge, but also they want to get a few sort of kills with Pebbles. He's got the Portal Key, and he hasn't really sort of used it. So I'd like to see him get kills, particularly on the Magus and Rhapsody, because Soul Reaper is going to be really hard to kill. So is Drunken, and so is Solstice. So the only two heroes he really has a possibility to kill is the Magus and Rhapsody. But those will be enough to sort of get them back in the game in terms of golden XP.
Yeah, Diglett playing the Magus again. He kind of been quiet with himself, but he's only 177 gold per minute. So understandably, I haven't talked too much about him. And again, the Portal Key is not going to be coming just yet either. He did get the Steam Boots first on top of the Power Supply, so getting some decent early game here, but probably going to see that Portal Key next in line. I mean, is there a case where you can maybe see just skipping a Portal Key, or is it still, you just have to?
No, I mean, the Portal Key is definite must, particularly on a Suicide Magmus. Like, getting that Eruption is all he really needs to do, to do his part, and that's a little bit where Legion are sort of lacking. They need that sort of team fight and that kind of thing that brings it all together. They got the Solstice ulti, but the stun and the Eruption combo from Magmus is what's really going to form Legion's team fight. So yeah, he'd definitely need that Portal Key, because otherwise, like, getting the Lava Surge and Eruption off is going to be really difficult without a Portal Key.
Yeah. All right, so again, keep an eye on that, probably, again, next in line to come up here. So again, with that Gnome's Wisdom, first item on Beaverbanger, playing this Soul Reaper here, we'll kind of wonder what route he's going to follow. I mean, if he follows that push route, you'd almost think something like an Astrolabe, but...
Yeah, I mean, Astrolabe could work, though. Like, he's already gone the Gnome's Wisdom, so it looks like as if... The Last of Us want to sort of maybe push their advantage and their lead. So, I mean, Astrolabe would work fine, to be honest. Like, it'd give him sort of the push, but also the team fight.
Yeah.
I'd like to see Drunken get his Shrunken first, because, like, otherwise he's not going to be doing that much. I mean, he's going to get locked down by Keeper, Engineer, ulti, as well as Pebbles combo. So if they do want to take a team fight, I think Shrunken on Drunken is definitely a must.
All right.
But, yeah, game's back under. Yeah, he does dodge it in the end.
Nice sidestep.
But I mean, like, having this 4k gold lead, though, although it seems quite a lot, it's not that much, particularly since it's going against a Moonqueen as well as a Keeper. Like, that team fight, and especially in the late game, is really devastating. Mm-hmm. So as long as Reason don't get too far behind, they should be doing fine in terms of, like, their game strategy and execution of it.
Yeah, no, I mean, we sit here, we talk about games where they're down by 20,000 gold, and they have a Moonqueen, though, so it's like, it's never out of it. They have a Moonqueen. So
exactly.
I think 4,000 is more than reasonable.
Yeah.
To not be too far out of it. So again, she went the Firebrand here. Understandable. Sackstone. Coming out from Soul
I think Sackstone can definitely work, but I mean, at the moment, it's not been offering that much. I mean, Pebble's obviously doing, like, everyone's sort of doing mainly magical, except for Moonqueen, which will have more of an effect in the late game, because at the moment, like, there's not a lot of physical presence coming out from Reason.
Yeah.
But at the same time, it does offer more pushing power as well, though, so it's not the baddest of iron pickups, though. There could be worse, obviously.
Oh, yeah. You see Rhapsody. She's actually running around with that Invisory and the Strider. She does have Dust now, so, again, kind of almost learning from the mistake earlier.
Soul Reaper might be in trouble. I mean, Pebbles does have a... Oh, no, middle lane.
What are they doing in middle lane? Oh, wow, yeah, they're going to the Pebbles right here. Gets a tower kill, but at what cost here for Provost? Can he actually escape? Portal Key going to be coming up in 4 seconds, it looks like. I don't know about this. He's like, he dodges a stagger, but no. In comes the lunge, and down goes Pebbles. That was very close.
That play was a little bit questionable. Like, I understand that he wants to get the tower kill, but, like, the main thing about getting the tier 1 tower, especially middle, is more just for the map control. Like, although Deny does sort of give them a lot of gold less, it's the map control that Reason really do need. They need to offer that sort of space for Moonqueen. Like, she's going to get loads of farm anyway, so getting the tower kill isn't really a must. And getting a death on your main sort of initiator and the playmaker in this game isn't the best. So, but maybe they just wanted the tower kill, but yeah, not the bestest of decisions coming out from ProBrusk in my opinion.
Yeah, got the tower, but that could have easily been a deny and still a death too.
Yeah, so exactly.
That would have obviously been the absolute worst case scenario, but in the end, at least got the tower kill. Now, Shrunken Head is stressing that, especially for the Drunken Master. He basically has it here at 2,800 gold. So within the next minute, he'll be, on him.
I think that's when they're sort of stop making a move. The Last of Us, unless they want to get a Shrunken on Solstice as well, which is definitely a possibility. They're far up ahead. Like I've said it before, like if, as long as you're sort of old middle lane.
Yeah, Drunken Master, he's going to be caught right here. Gets chucked back to his teammates. In comes the Moonbeam. The Untouchable is now walked through. He's staggering around. He goes on a Moon Queen and lunges him away. In comes the Energy Field, but it's too late. He was just not in time. Solstice, ulti just in case. They kept chasing, but they did not. So in the end, though, he gets away, man.
I think Adro was sort of scared to use ult. He didn't want to waste it, but at the same time, he missed his keg stun, and those two things are the two things that he must hit. Though, if they're gonna get that Drunken Master, like everything needs to be going off. Like he's the sort of a priority target for the Last of Us, so they really do need to take him down. Yeah. But unfortunate coming up.
I mean,
from
what a strong ability, man, Untouchable. Not only does it mitigate target cast, but it also reduces your damage taken by up to 40%. At level 16, it really is such a strong ability.
Really strong. Like, this is why like this hero is getting first picked all the time, pretty much in the competitive scene. Like also his sort of versatility. We saw him actually like lane mid here, but normally we sort of see him in the suicide. But he can work in the short lane as a carry. That's why a lot of the competitive heroes actually are being used mainly because of their versatility. Because in the draft, particularly, it's hard to know what your enemy's doing as well as your own game plan and your own strategy. So having these heroes that can really be versatile is really strong because they can lane and work in any sort of lineup, which is always useful for a drafter.
Yeah. Drunken Master doing some roam here again. He has that Shrunken Head now. Looking to find somebody, but probably not going to happen here. You see the Shaman's Headdress finished in full on Soul Reaper in the meantime. So just being a very big team utility kind of team support tank.
Yeah, that's fine. Like, but it looks like they want to go sort of team fighting soon, and getting the Shaman's Headdress is fine. Like, as long as Soul Reaper sort of survives, he's going to be doing a lot of damage, but more importantly, he's going to be doing a lot of survivability for his team, because at the moment, like, Drunken and Solstice are going to be the main threats in terms of damage, and it's sort of Soul Reaper who's going to be sort of healing him up, almost like in MMO. He's going to be like the healer, pretty much, for this team. Like, as long as he survives, which is good, because he's got the Shaman's Headdress, because Pebbles is most likely going to be trying to sort of lock him down with a combo, and with that Shaman's Headdress, he shouldn't be able to be bursting down as easily.
Yeah. Moon Queen has enough for Geometer Spin if she wanted that, but might just go straight Shrunken here next.
Yeah.
Follow up.
But going back to this Soul Reaper, though, like, this hero is actually going to have a lot of a better impact, particularly in this game compared to others, because in this game, there's a lot of like big ultimates that are going to be used, and after the ultimates come out for Reason Gaming, that is, there's not much they sort of offer other than the Moon Queen. Like, after Kiva always, after Engineer always, and after Pebbles does his combo, there's not a lot of sort of presence and damage in this team fight. So as long as sort of Soul Reaper can sort of survive and sort of heal up, this survivability is actually going to be a real factor in these team fights, I believe.
Oh yeah, and Soul Reaper bottom lane though, he might. I mean, again, I want to say he might be in trouble, but at the same time, he's a tank, man. He's a tank with that Sackstone, the Shaman's Headdress, so unless they commit like 3 or 4 heroes.
And this is where they need Pebbles to be their playmaker. Like, I don't sort of criticize ProBrusk for farming mid, because he wants to get that Demonic as well, but like, you can't really be ganking with a Kiva, because like, although the ult is good, it's more good like in an AoE than for a single gank on a single hero, and like, the two supports aren't going to be offering a lot in terms of damage as well, so trying to kill someone like a Soul Reaper is going to be really, really difficult for them.
Yeah, it's not going to happen without the likes of that Pebbles, most likely, especially, so instead, they will just continue to farm for now, but both teams continue to play the farm game.
Yeah, like, and I think as long as The Last of Us don't take it, like, super, super late, I think they should be fine. Like, if they sort of try and find, like, a timing before, bottom lane.
We're going to see just how tanky he is. Here comes Pebbles in. Everybody's here, and he will fall. That's what we're talking about. They almost needed everybody. Well, they bring everybody.
Yeah, it's fine though. Like, getting that pick off is quite a big deal, because like, obviously Soul Reaper doesn't have a buyback, and so getting a T1 bottom is fine. But it looks like they might try and defend this, which is kind of strange. But I mean, Kiba Oli is down, so is Engineer, so they might be able to.
Here we go. The Kamehameha. It's going to hit all five at this point. It comes out right there. Magma sends it as well to Moon Queen. There's a launch full out. Moon Queen's dead right off the bat. Pebbles, he did not get caught. He is stuck in the trees down here. He does have a portal key, but the chase continues up here. Aluna's now going to be a lot of trouble, and I don't think Pebbles is going to look to assist. Nice red stun, but it probably won't matter. There's the lunge, and down goes Aluna in the end.
They took me by surprise, but I think they took Reason by surprise as well. I think Reason were definitely saying, oh, we got a kill on Soul Reaper, let's just push bottom. Yeah. With 5v4, can't lose a team fight. But that Soul Stealth, he's showing us again how strong that sort of AoE presence actually is on that hero. Like, it lined up perfectly, it hit all five, and then Magnus came in and stunned, and Moon Queen wasn't able to do a single spell.
Yeah.
Like, that's really,
I mean, the Knight version's obviously so strong for the initiation. Yeah, they find Pebbles. They like, knew he was there the whole time. I mean, it's as if they were acting like
he was so unlucky. Like, the courier, like, ran over his head. That's so unlucky. That's... Oh, man, I feel so bad for Probus. He'd be fine, but...
Yeah, that almost looked like they, like, planned that, like, oh, we don't know you're here. Oh, now we're going to jump you. But you're right. Yeah, the courier just happened to go over him.
That's so unlucky. But now, I mean, the Last of Us are really, really in control of this game right now. There's not much that Reason can do, especially with their sort of team lineup. This is the team lineup that sort of needs to be ahead and can go late game. But as they're sort of 10k gold behind, there's not much they can really do, because they don't have a lot of playmakers. They've got Pebbles, but it showed before that sort of going all five for one hero doesn't always work. But the Last of Us are doing the right thing. They're going as five because I think they know they can't lose a team fight right now, so they're going to be able to take like most of the tier one towers down.
Oh yeah, and again, I was going to say Solstice. I mean, he's proven that how strong of an initiating tool that can be.
He's been landing some insane ultimate stuff. Like, look at what he's doing again. Like, he's climbing into these trees. Yeah, putting himself in the perfect position to take any big team fights with his ulti.
Yeah, obviously not going to happen. But yeah, might as well get ready just in case. But this is going to be a free tower kill in the end.
Reason doing the right thing. Like, they know they can't take a team fight anymore, so they're just going to try and split push their way to victory. Like, they've got a Moon Queen, so they still have hope. But obviously, it's very, very unlikely. But,
here we go again. Take two. You think Reason Gaming's going to pick up on this?
They know. But they know, like, if they take another team fight and they lose, this game is most likely like finished. So they're going to just try and survive and hold on to the late game. Like, Moon Queen can definitely offer miracles, so they're going to just hope for a miracle in Ember Boy on his Moon Queen, which is definitely a possibility. Like, we've seen this hero, like, destroy, even from, like, 20k behind, so...
Oh, yeah. Again, that's what he does. What is going on here? Pebbles found a kill. Now he's going to go for the TP. They should be fine. Yeah, Magma's already stunned. So, good find.
Yeah, definitely. Like, it's a risky play, but like I've said before, if you're really far down, like, it's those risky plays that you need to make because, like, you need something to happen. You need some sort of something to get back into the game, and doing those risky plays, although it might cost you the game, like, you need those kind of plays to get back into it. Oh, well, Luna might be in trouble. No, she's fine.
Oof.
Risky.
Magnus could not see her.
They should be doing those risky plays though, because they need them to get back into this game.
All right, so Solstice. Now he's starting to get to a point. 2,900 more gold saved up. He's got his farming tools into his fighting team fight tool. Now where does he go? Cause some kind of damage focus, you think?
I think damage is fine. Like, I've seen a few items go. I'd like to see him maybe go Shieldbreaker or Rift Shards. I know it sounds a little bit troll, but that sort of damage item can do so much damage. Like, he gets extra movement speed from his Q.
Yeah.
And that sort of crit coming out from the wrist shots can really do it. Or the basher can work as well, actually.
Okay.
I'd like to see him maybe go Shield Breaker or wrist shots after it, though, because like, he's got the survivability from Soul Reaper, so like, he can afford to go more damage items, in my opinion.
Yep, got that Brutalizer. So again, he's hitting like a truck now, and doing some good damage. Only three hero kills in total, man, for Reason Gaming. Again, this has not been an active game.
And I'd like to point out that this is, I think I've said it before at the start of the draft, that, like, this isn't really something that Reason really do. I like when they go, like, the dual supports and they get aggressive and go for the early game, like, sort of win. But, like, this is something I haven't really seen Reason do, and it's really not really working for them that much. So maybe in the second game they might resort back to their basics and what they're sort of comfortable with.
Oh, yeah. 100% agree there. But, again, there is still this game left. Keep going back to, especially with the Moon Queen factor. It's only 11,000 gold late, 11,000 experience. It's nice, but if they manage to come through in a team fight, which they most certainly can, especially with the Restill Stone, but that's still in the works here, of course, for Keeper. But we might have a find here. They're scouting.
I mean, and like potentially also because of like Last of Us not being extremely sort of experienced, they can easily like make a throw that can put reason back into it. So I think it's the right decision to keep playing on though. Like they've got a Moon Queen as well, so definitely a possibility.
See, I like Soul Reaper is at it. I like, but at the same time, it's like it's just so fun. There's not a whole lot of physical presence, even with a farmed Moon Queen. It's not like the most. It's not like your drunken master crazy farmed, or I don't know. This build just seems odd.
I could even see him go Shrunken Head though, like because as long as he gets like a lot of his judgments off and his ultimate, like with a Shrunken Head, he's not going to be stopped by Keeper or like Pebbles or even Engineer. So I think Shrunken could have even worked this game as well. But like I said, like with this high armor build, like it's not the biggest deal really. But it's his item choice, so it seems to be working out anyway.
We've been criticizing it the whole game, and here he is, you know, his team's up there.
He's still doing really well, but I don't know. I just think in theory, the iron builds are a little bit weird, but you know, it's the biggest of deals.
I 100% agree.
I mean, like Pebbles does do quite a bit of damage as well as Moon Queen, but I think it's like the items he's got now like do work in the late game. I just think for the items he's got now, it's not the biggest of deals. But
That was close at the bottom line. They almost set up a Giga on Keeper, but he fell back just before. They were able to jump him, so... Oh, there's a find. Apparently, Magnus going to find a Luna. He was sitting on the ward side. He's going to try to block him now, but he's not going to get the team support in time, so... At least a Luna does survive, but they're going to take some... Only a single Sack Agents here. In the meantime, nearly 3,000 gold saved up on Drunken Master, though. So he's going to have another big item himself, probably a full Demonic Breastplate at this point. Again, so is Pebbles. He actually gets the Mighty Blade. So I wonder if he's just going to switch that up to a... Drunken Head, or maybe that was the intention all along, but gonna go for the more defensive team fight item.
Self setting up as well for middle lane.
I think
Reason are doing the right thing. Like I said before, they can't really take a team fight. They have actually reduced their golden XP advantage or deficit by like 1,000 each way. So like as long as they keep farming, they can slowly claw this game back actually. But no, like they can't take a team fight, so split pushing is exactly what they need to do. Moon Queen is getting quite far though. She's 483 gold per minute. Yeah. Like if she can get maybe the symbol of rage, like it will really put her in a nice position, so she can't really get bursted down by the Solstice or Magma Salty.
Yeah, I keep looking at that GPM chart, and even though they continue to compete here in the lead, it's just like he's just pointed out. Moon Queen just ever so slightly ahead and continue to be on top somehow. But Ember Boy obviously a great farming player in general, and Moon Queen by all means. Very effective at that, so that is continuing to be that, at least a little bit of shining hope that our Hellborn team has. And again, like I also mentioned earlier, the Restoration Stone is now just around the corner. He's got the Arcana, so he needs the 1875 pattern.
That would be a really, really big pickup, though, because it's only Drunken that's got... Oh, no, Drunken and Solstice have got the Drunken heads, but obviously they're going to get caught on the second Resto... Yeah. Keep bolting, and that's going to be like a really big factor. I think it depends on the initiation coming out from The Last of Us, though. Like, if they get a big Solstice ult in a big map, I don't think there's a lot that Reason can really do. So I think the initiation will have to be in the hands of Reason to start things. Like Pebbles, if he can combo the Solstice or the Magnus to stop them getting a good ulti off, I think that'll be the key difference in winning these team fights.
See, there you go. Shrunken Head on Pebbles now, so.
Yeah, because I think like we've seen like all the team fights coming out from The Last of Us are being in their favor because of these Solstice ultis. These Solstice ultis have been so big. Like if they catch everyone, that's like 800 damage to every single hero, and that's like ridiculous amount of team fight. Like pair that with like a Magmus as well, and there's not much that Reason can do.
Middle lane, Shrunken Master. He pops the Shrunken Head. He's gonna start staggering away, and guess what? He's gonna be fine. So commit to
it
right
big.
There.
Off, actually.
Yeah. Yeah, he would not have had buyback, so. Could have made something happen, perhaps, but.
They could Hongo, particularly if they were Hellborn as well. But no, I didn't get it. But yeah, going back to what I was going to say as well, like with Solstice ulti, like, obviously it's going to be happening almost instantly, because although he's charging up, like, Reason won't have any idea he's charging it. So when that damage comes out, that's 800 damage. Like that's not going to be stopped by Shrunken Head, because the Solstice is going to charge the ulti, and then it's going to happen, and then they're going to pop the Shrunken Head. So it's going to be 800 damage down from everyone, which is going to be like a big factor in these team fights.
Yeah. So again, I mean, I was mentioning the 3 kills only for Reason Hell. There's only 9 here on the Last of Us. 12 kills total in nearly 33 minutes now. Obviously, one of our more slower-paced games we've had here in this Crimes of Caldivar event, but it definitely can happen, and obviously we're seeing that here. Both teams really focused on playing the farm game. But and this definitely, you got to bring this back to The Last of Us, too. We always talk about the time. I mean, hell, you were even referring to earlier. As long as you don't go to the late game, you know, that's all in theory and everything. But so when are they going to make a move, man? I mean, when is that item that comes out that they I don't know.
I don't know if it's actually going to be an item. I think it might be like if they get a pickoff and then they're going to go. Because at the moment, like, it looks like they've got all they need. They've got the Shrunken on Drunken. They've got Shrunken on Solstice as well. Like, and at the moment, it looks like they're just sort of piling gold. Although they are moving top, so that could potentially be a push top. But yeah, I think it might come down to if they get a pickoff, then they're going to go. But I hope they don't wait too long. But yeah, Soul Reaper is coming top, actually. So that could be the reason why. He's got his... He's got his what's it called?
Frostfield plate.
That's it. And that could be the difference. It looks like they are sort of joining up now. They know they can't go super late game with Moon Queen. It looks like they are sort of going together.
That was really cool because Moon Queen, she actually stood there for a second because she was using the courier, and I almost thought they were going to be able to jump her as a result of that. So she did start running away though, and obviously is fine in the long run. But yeah, I mean, going back to my point, it's. There is such a thing as waiting too long when you're far ahead. I mean, you are at a point where you want to just simply get the job done at the bottom lane. They are going to chase Pebbles down. Will he be able to follow it up? Stacker comes in. Nice Shrunken head uses though, and Probusk does get away.
That would have been so. If they called Pebbles there, that could have been Kongor and then Rax at the same time. That would have been really big. Although they are taking Kongor now, but it's going to get scattered out.
Yeah.
But if they took out Pebbles there, that could have been the difference. But look, they got Keeper, Resto Stone, and they're closing on Wingbow from Moon because they want to take this team fight. This could be a real, real big game changer right now.
Go. Are we going to see an actual fight brewing here? Well, definitely brewing. Will it actually take place? Moon Queen, that's the real Moon Queen right there, kind of going up in front. Pebble Sticks is under the background. Those are just illusions, the one left behind. Of course, Drunken Master, he's going to be gone. In comes our first River Keeper of the Force. He does have two. The lockdown, the Pebbles fall up. Sorry for no in comes our technicality from behind. Gonna save all that damage coming out. Finally, the second root hit. Moon Queen sitting right on top of them right here, but she is all by herself basically. Keeper of the Force somewhat nearby. Not a whole lot more he can do though. Can Moon Queen survive this somehow? Probably not. Red Ward's down, that's not theirs though. And actually he is gonna live. Pebbles buys back. Stalagmites hits two right there. Soul Reaper and Drunken. Drunken goes down. Soul Reaper for the turn kill. No, he cannot get it. But down goes Keeper of the Force, and now Probusk, he's in trouble. All of a sudden he cannot get that portal key off. The Illuminate distracting from that. We do see Solstice chasing. Can he get a charge off, maybe? Yes, he can. The Lava Surge as well. Pebbles will fall once again in the fight. Moon Queen died.
Yeah,
oh, I didn't even realize that.
Yeah, if the judgment coming out from Soul Reaper, that chased him the whole way.
Wow.
And he eventually met his fate.
All right, I mean.
Yeah. That was.
It seemed like Reason actually had a decent jump there, but.
They had a great sort of. Oh, Aluna's being pulled out.
Yeah, they're just trying to harass them, but that's going to be a combo.
Yeah, it looked like it was going to be a good teamfight kind of reason. Like, you saw Fuzzy Sloth as well as Diglett, like, using a lot of their spells, like, on illusions from Moon Queen, and that would have been, like, been a perfect initiation if they had gotten the Moon Queen, but obviously they missed him, and so that was the perfect time for Reason to really start their teamfight, and they did, but it was. I think it's mainly because of the gold lead. They were still 10k gold behind, and I think that was the difference between them losing and winning the teamfight.
Yeah. I mean, Mook was in the midst of them all. The Moon Finale activated. I'm sure did a plenty of damage in that fight. Again, that was not a place where there's many creeps nearby, of course. But in the end, that wore out the second route. The Protective Melody, again, no doubt, as it usually comes to. It was a full duration, I believe. It lasted the full 5 seconds at that point. And obviously, if that happens, you know, your chances of winning a fight, too, is very little.
Moon Queen is closing in on the Wingbow, and that's going to be a real big factor. Like, they've got a lot of physical presence now with Solstice and Drunken. And with that Wingbow, like, Moon Queen shouldn't really be able to fall unless she gets picked off and bursted down before she gets her Shrunken head off. And so, like, the game's still alive here for a reason. It's just they're definitely on the back foot. They need to sort of hope for a miracle, to be honest.
Yeah.
But it's definitely not over.
Not 100% over. Once again, the Moon Queen factor. But
when you have a Moon Queen, it's never over.
Like I said, that's a trademark term. Moon Queen factor. It is a thing. She is going Wingbow, and actually, did she just get it? Yes. So that's increased her range by 100, as well as gives her that invasion effect and just the raw stats, obviously.
I think her next iron pickup though has to be that symbol of rage. Like the Wingbow's fine, like that could have been a symbol either way, but like she needs to get that symbol, not only because it's gonna help her like sort of to stay up in team fights, but if she gets picked off or bursted down before she gets a stronger node, that's gonna be like a real bad factor. And then that, obviously that symbol is gonna sort of beef her up her a bit before for initiations and stuff.
So yeah. Top lane. Seems like The Last of Us is making another push up here. They got their cooldowns ready. So does the Hellborn team, though.
Legion just stay up here, though, because like, they ain't got any TPs to TP back, but they can take Brax before Hellborn. Although, I think Hellborn, they should definitely get back for the Rax, though, because they don't want to lose Rax. But I don't think they'd be able to get Rax for a reason, actually. Yes, they are pulling back, which is the right decision, but if they lose this team fight here, this could be game for the Last of Us.
This is where Zorper also really does, not only does shine earlier, but his ultimate is going to very much shine, the Demonic Execution. You get Moon Queen just basically just below half life, and you pretty much have a guaranteed kill almost.
Definitely.
As a result of that. So, granted, you know, the Shrunken Egg can cause issues, sure, but the point is still there that she's very susceptible, even though she has 2,000 life here, and with that evasion aspect. But obviously, they need to be very careful. Pebble's going in, he chucks back Soulreaper to his team. Energy Field comes out. The team support trying to get in here in time, but Soulreaper is so tanky. The real Moon Queen in the meantime. Moon Finale's up. The Shrunken Eggs are up as well. The second root has not been used just yet. Eruption comes in from Magma's number. No one stopped immediately. By Keeper of the Forest in the background. Great stop right there. Rhapsody falls. Soulreaper trying to take the damage as he can. He uses the Boom Ghost of Dynamite on Pebbles. And guess what? Solstice is still well alive as well. So right now it's just the two of them, though. Yeah, Pebbles is second and final buyback. They're going to chase a little bit right here. Moon Queen's out of mana currently. Or very, very low at least. But they still want to commit to this. I don't know about this. They got to be careful, honestly. As, yeah, Iluna goes down. Maybe Solstice. Soulreaper's run. I don't know why Soulreaper's running, man. I feel like Soulreaper could have at least helped a little bit right there. But no. And now it's him versus Moon Queen and Pebbles all of a sudden. He doesn't have ultimate, though. Yeah, he's not going to win this battle. Probably going to end up falling back from one another in the end. But wow.
Yeah, that's a good hold, though. Like, I mean, although Pebbles bought uses last buyback, like they need to do that, although it was going to definitely lose their game. But it was a good hold, though. Like, particularly Zane's patience in that team fight was absolutely perfect. Like, he used his first brute to catch all five, and he stayed back waiting for that Rhapsody. Oh, the Rhapsody went off, but only for like 0.5 seconds, and that's a really big factor. Like, if that Rhapsody ulti was stayed on any longer, that could have definitely been a complete wipe. For The Last of Us, but as a really well played by Zane there, just holding on, being patient.
Yeah, that was a hell of a hold indeed. I agree with you 100% there. And like you said, the great patience by Zane, and especially when they learned that last fight, if anything, just kind of making the quick adjustment there and knowing that he had to save the second one for that purpose. So, big time, big hold right there. But again, the lead overall still is in favor of The Last of Us quite a bit. And you got a behemoth heart now on Soulreaper.
Oh, man, that's a big pickup. Like you saw in that team fight, like after sort of Keeper used all his spells and sort of Engineer, like and everyone, like there wasn't a lot of damage coming out really. Like Moon Queen, yeah, she's quite fine, but she's still not at the point where she's gonna be like an absolute wrecking ball. Like she did quite a lot of damage, but it's not enough really to sort of cut through this Legion tankiness,
okay.
Really, especially Soulreaper.
Well, you want damage? He gets another Quick Blade. He's gonna be going against Yuro.
I think that is the right pickup. Like I said before, like, I'd like to see him pick up the Symbol of Rage, but Legion aren't really sort of focusing this Moon Queen, so she definitely needs more damage, which like the Dance Blade is fine. I think he's going to go with the Gendura, obviously, which would be good for like the extra damage, but as they're not focusing this Moon Queen, like she doesn't need to go Symbol, which is fine. In the end, like it's one of those pickups where like I like this sort of play coming out from Imberboy, because like, maybe on paper, on theory, like the Symbol of Rage might be the better pickup, but he knows that he's not being targeted, so he can go and afford to get the extra damage.
Drunken Master, man, 4,600 gold now saved up. What should he be looking for here?
I think the Shield Breaker will like really do work here. Like they haven't got one yet, and like this Keeper armor is sort of making everyone sort of survive longer. So something that sort of cuts through a lot of this armor coming out from Keeper, like even Rift Shards can work. But I think Shield Breaker is probably the way to go, unless he's going to go Heart as well, which is potentially. I think goes Geo Bones. That's fine actually at the same time, because obviously he's going to get out of Keeper root twice.
It is one of those funky items, as the, obviously not being an agility hero himself, but at the same time, you get it. Like, you're just staying there. Second Rue, you want to be able to get out of that, so.
It's fine, like, because, like, although I said damage, like, almost the Geomancer's Bane is damaged, because if he's getting locked down from Keeper, obviously he's not offering any damage at all. So as long as he's like uncontested in these team fights, he's going to be doing a lot of damage anyway. So yeah, the Geo's fine. I'd definitely like to see like a Rift Shards or a Shieldbreaker next fight though, because he's got the Shrunken.
I don't even know if we mentioned. Oh, top lane. Yeah, we got Sorcerer running into them right here. Keeper the Forest chasing. Is he going to root? Obviously he has a Drunkenmaster nearby. There's a quick portal key from Keeper. I think the second he saw Drunken, he's like, I'm out of here.
Yeah, I think that, although like Reason didn't know, I think that would have been like somewhat of a good fight. The Magmus wasn't really near, and all five of Reason were together, but like if there were all five there, that could have been the wipe and that could have been the game. Like, it's a lot better to fight in your own base just because of like the uphill advantage and stuff, so
yeah.
Just safe play coming out from Reason, which is fine. They've got the Moon Queen here, they just wanna hold on as long as they can.
Once again, hanging around the top lane. I don't know if we mentioned the Hellflower on Solstice, but...
Oh, no, we haven't.
The Hellflower here.
I don't know. It's okay pickup, but at the same time, like, he's going to be staying back to try and do, like, a big ult in. So, for the use of the Hellflower, I don't think he's going to use it that much, really, particularly for anything useful, but we'll see there.
They're pretty much going full force. Touchable's already up. The Rally Rex will be survived initially. Solstice in the meantime gets chucked back in. Solstice is going to be locked down to death right there. Second route ready to go for Keeper. When it calls for it right now, obviously Solstice dead. Sorry for he's a tank, but he's going to take some damage right here. Magmus does back in, actually. I don't know about that. Second route does come out, and they're committed full force to a fight right here. Moon Queen in the meantime splits up with the Illusions. In the background, though, Drunken Master gets the one kill. Protect him out and coming out, and a well save Magmus initially. The real Moon Queen, she's going to fall. Big Diglett stun right there. Hits three heals, including killing Moon Queen, who buys back instantly. But Keeper the Force falls. That's going to be a Rax cleanup, and everyone else stays alive.
Oh,
vote to concede. I think that might do it.
GG. That was a really good initiation, like coming out for Reason. That's the perfect initiation actually for Reason, but obviously yeah, they just were too far behind on Golden XP. Like, they tossed back Solstice into the Engineer role, and like Solstice got absolutely nothing off in the end.
Yeah.
The four heroes from Legion were just enough to finish off Reason in the end, but good game though. I'd like to see potentially something different coming out from Reason, potentially maybe like the more aggressive early sort of dual support to tri lane, perhaps like going back to what they used to in the second game.
Yeah, you know, you refer that to the very beginning of the draft, and you know, definitely could credit that to perhaps on the losing side throughout that game overall, but I think you also got to credit a lot to The Last of Us, obviously, and their play. But even granted, again, with some questionable, their synergy, the lineup, even though they won this game, you think it's something you can very much say, on paper, didn't really make a lot of sense. But
it doesn't matter. Like, as long as you sort of do well in practice, it doesn't really matter about the theory, really.